This portion is brought to you by Mercury Drug, na kasi siguro gamot ay laging bago.
Today on Generation RX Plus, let's talk about estrogen once more and its relationship to women's health. And this time we're going to find out the effects of estrogen to the cervix. So stay tuned and learn in our Ask the Experts. Still reminiscing over the past holidays? Well, here's one way to relieve it. Get to dine in style as we feature more about the food club and what it got in store for you on our La Mesa Jam. And who said that you can't be a mermaid? Well, this kid will prove everyone wrong. Get to know her and how she's turning her dream into a reality on our Kid Power. All these and more on Generation RX Plus.
Last episode, we talked about the effect of estrogen and breast tumors. Now, does estrogen affect the cervix? Does it cause cervical cancer? More on estrogen and how it affects the cervix from our expert in today's episode. Good morning, this is your host, Dr. Cecil Katapang, and you are watching Generation RX Plus.
We all have them in our body. They are known as hormones at malaki ang kanilang ginagampanan sa ating katawan. Dumadaan ang mga ito sa ating bloodstream to our tissues or organs at malaki ang epekto nila sa mga iba't ibang proseso na nangyayari sa atin tulad ng growth and development, reproduction, and even our mood. But there's a group of hormone compounds that are quite unique to women. They are generally called estrogen. Bagaman meron din ito sa mga kalalakihan, ibang-iba ang papel naman nito sa mga kababaihan.
Estrogen is a female sex hormone that play an essential role in the growth and development of a female's secondary sexual characteristics. The cervix is the lower portion of the uterus which connects to the vaginal wall. It is 2 to 3 cm long and is cylindrical in shape. The cervix is also known as cuello ng matres. In layman's term, estrogen levels rise prior to ovulation, causing the cervix to swell and soften. It also thickens the cervical mucus, enhancing sperm transport. Actually, we cannot really tell if estrogen could be an asset or a liability to the cervix. If the cervix is not diseased, the estrogen could be helpful to the patient. But if it's already diseased, like with the exposure of human papillomavirus, estrogen can proliferate the cells of the abnormal cells, causing more aggressive disease entity.
Although maganda naman ang naidudulot ng estrogen sa mga kababaihan, there are those who claim that too much of it can also bring problems.
Cervical cells has been shown to contain estrogen receptors. It responds to persistent exposure to chronic estrogen, so that would be harmful to the cervix. If the patient cervix is already diseased, no, caution should be given to the patient. But puraria mirifica can also be of help, especially if the patient is already in the menopause state and experiencing vaginal dryness and decrease in sex drive.
There's no doubt that there are ways in which to treat cervical problems. Ngunit mas maigi pa rin ang magpakonsulta sa inyong doktor.
The FDA recommends that hormone therapy, whether in the form of a medicinal plant or a synthetic compound, be used at the lowest possible dose and shortest duration to achieve treatment goals. Physicians should discuss with the patients the possible risks and the benefits that they could get with that medication.
You probably have not known before that estrogen does contribute to the onset and malignant progression of cervical cancers. So now you have a better understanding on how to avoid this type of tumors. The Generation RX Plus team would like to thank Plantation Bay Resort and Spa, and I would like to thank Metathion for my whitening hair, Malunggay Life Oil for giving me the pure power of Mother Nature, Color Collection Cosmetics by Tupperware Brand for my makeup, Make Me Blush for my hair and nail care, and Look Young, Move Young, Feel Young, and Discover New Youth with Hi-C from Fine Japan. Again, we here at Generation RX Plus remind you to live well so you can play well.